for one of football's most famous fixtures. Kirby again. Ellen White scores. Magoo. Oh, stunning free kick. Mini Bright. Frank Kirby, what a run. And what a finish as well. And the clinching goal for the Arnold Cracker.
Hello and welcome to Molyneux, where back in February, the Lionesses beat Germany and lifted the Arnold Clark Cup. And now, with just under 3 weeks to go, they set their sights firmly on the Euros.
It means absolutely everything to represent my country. It's an absolute dream.
The biggest honour of my life.
And England wants it, England gets it! Oh, that's a finish. Millie Bright at the double. Mead! Oh, brilliant! Hat-trick for Beth Mead! So well, another hat-trick, and the 10 is up again. Mead scoops it over. Positives all round for the Lionesses.
Yesterday, Serena Wiegmann announced her squad for the Euros, and former captain Steph Orton has not been deemed fit and ready, and she doesn't make the final 23. Frank Kirby and Jill Scott are both in, as is Chloe Kelly, the Manchester City striker, who's not yet played under Serena. Now, the Euro starts in just under 3 weeks, and England have three matches against top opposition before they start. We will show all three of them on ITV4. Their first opponents are Belgium, who've qualified for a major tournament for just the second time in their history, and that's followed by the Netherlands and Switzerland too. Well, today I'm joined by one of my heroes in Ian Wright and one of Ian Wright's heroes in Kelly Smith. It is just wonderful to have you both here. Thank you so much for joining us.
Cheers,
both
man.
Legends for both Arsenal and England as well. And for anyone that's forgotten about that, this is what it looks like. Ian Wright there. Look at you there, Ian. Remember
what
that pay?
Fitting.
That was amazing. Against Italy. Oh, my gosh.
Kelly, don't worry. We've got some of you as well. This is for England as well.
Oh, I love this goal. One of my favourites for England against the Netherlands. Always happy to represent England.
And of course, always happy to represent Arsenal, right?
Yeah, that's cool.
Well, both of you there, both of you representing club and country, so it's a real pleasure to have you here.
Thanks a lot.
Speaking of country, we saw the squad, one of the biggest shocks, perhaps the only shock really, no Steph Orton, the former England captain. What do you think? Is that the right decision for you, righty?
I think it's the right decision in the end. I was very surprised that Serena put her in the first place. When you look at the season, she'd only played six games, you know, she's not played for Serena yet. You know, you've got Lotta Woodham-Moy, you've got Jess Carter in there. Who would have missed out? I think that she made a mistake bringing her in because she brought it all on herself. So when you saw her in the press conference getting a little bit upset by people asking the questions, she's got to take that, because bringing her in when you've got every reason to not bring her in because you're going in a different way with the leadership group and everything, I think that she's got to take that on her chin, simply because that's the decision she made. And it's unfortunate for Steph because she got herself into a squad, Kells, where she thought, well, I haven't done everything to get in there, so she must be bringing me in there for something. And in the end, she's been taken out. So I feel for her, but it is the right decision, I think.
Kelly?
Yeah, I do feel for Steph. It's a hard pill to swallow. You know, I know I've played with Steph a number of times for England and Arsenal, and she's such a good character to have around the team, good leadership skills. But this happens in football. You know, a similar thing happened to me in the build-up to the Olympics. I wasn't 100% fit. Lucky enough, Hope Powell picked me. So I've been there. I know how she's feeling. But Serena's been brought in as a manager to win a major tournament. And she sees this side without Steph Horton as doing that. And in 2017, when we did the Euros in Holland, Serena actually dropped her captain in the second game, and she didn't play for the rest of the tournament until she only gave her 2 minutes in the final. So she's cutthroat.
Exactly.
She knows the squad that she wants to have to win a tournament, and she thinks this is it.
That's it. She has to make hard decisions, and she has made them, and this is the 23-woman squad that she has picked. As we said, no Steph Horton. Just not ready to compete, those are the words of Serena Wiegmann. Frank Kirby is in. She hasn't had any game time since February, but apparently she's been doing quite well in training, been taking part in a few of those games. Chloe Kelly is in as well, the Manchester City striker. She's recovered from a serious knee injury. She's never played for Serena Wiegmann before either, and Wiegmann's named seven forwards in total. You can see in bottom right-hand side of your screen there. What do you think about that, righty?
I think it's very good. I've got to say, I'm very surprised Nikita Paris has made it with the form she's shown this season, and hopefully, you know, Serena's seen something that she can repay the faith. But in the main, you know, seeing Chloe Kelly in there, the way she's hit the ground running coming off of that injury, really glad to see her in there. Beth Mead obviously should be in there, you know, playing fantastically well, but I'm quite happy with that. We're going to need a lot of variety up front, so, you know, I'm happy with the players we've got up front.
Jill Scott as well. Jill Scott's in there. So much experience. But Serena was saying, look, it's what she does on the pitch first and foremost, before that experience. What was it for you, Kelly?
Yeah, no, I'm a big fan of Jill Scott. She's a real character in the dressing room. She likes to get players in, make some cups of coffees and tea, galvanises the squad. She's funny. She's a real good character to have around the team. And 156 caps, I think, for England. She's a leader in that dressing room too when things are going to get hard, you know, in the opening games. She's someone you need in your locker room.
I think when you saw her, the way she played against Alex Pateas in the Arnold Clark Cup, she's got something to offer. She could come on and do that kind of job if need be. So she's got a real purpose in this squad.
Yeah, I agree.
Okay. Well, how about we see how they start tonight? Because she's got three matches with this squad ahead of the Euros. And this is how they're lining up. So it's two changes from the last match that they played in against Northern Ireland. Alex Greenwood is out. She's got COVID. Yeah. Lotta Wubemoy is in. She replaces her. It's just her second start for England. She's going to partner Millie Bright in defence there. Millie Bright, congratulations. 50th cap today. Demi Stokes comes in for Ella Toon. Ella's dropped to the bench. You've got Hemp, White and Mead there, your front three. Very potent. Frank Kirby and Chloe Kelly as well are on the bench. It's a very strong team. We're going to discuss it in just a moment, but we're going to hear the thoughts of Serena Wiegmann now. She is speaking to Katie Shanahan.
Serena, great to see you back. What are you aiming to achieve from these three friendlies ahead of the Euros?
Yeah, three good friendlies. We want to play a lot, and then you need games to get ready for July 6th. I'm looking forward to tonight, and after that we have a review, and then the Netherlands and Switzerland. And then we should be ready. So good to play after having 3 weeks of training and show on the pitch where we are.
No Steph Horton in the Euro squad, as we know. Has that been the hardest decision you've had to make as England manager?
Well, it was a very, very hard decision. But for the other four players that we left out of the squad too, with Steph, she was injured. We did everything. She did everything to come back and to get ready for the Euros. But at the end, like for yesterday, she's not ready to compete yet, and the time is just too short with the level that's asked at Euros.
As for tonight, Lotta Wubemoy comes in with the likes of Alex Greenwood still recovering from COVID, it would seem. How far off is she from returning to the starting lineup?
Yeah, well, Alex is ready to play. She couldn't train with the group last week. She did some training, but she started the football trainings this week. She's ready, but not for a full game. Just like most of other players, they've had a holiday. Now we have 3 weeks of training, so we want to, if possible, manage the load a little bit.
So is that a similar situation for the likes of Chloe Kelly and Frank Kirby, who are also on the bench? What was the thinking behind that then?
Yeah, well, the starting line up front, there we are.
What a lovely reception.
Yes, it's nice. So the three starters for today and up front, they started a lot during the season. I started working with Chloe since the pre-camps, and she's done a great job. So yes, we really would like to see her in the game too, but she has to be a little patient and competing with the other three centre forwards. And the same with Fran. Fran is in a very good place, doing well, feeling good, but she hadn't played for a while. So, you know, building up slowly and getting ready for the 6th of July. So that's about it.
Thanks, Serena. Best of luck tonight.
Yes, thank you.
And here we go, the team out there on the pitch here at Molineux warming up. Chloe Kelly is an interesting topic, someone that we'd really like to see. Serena Wiegmann hasn't seen her in camp yet. She's got a real chance to prove herself off the bench today, maybe.
Well, she's somebody that, you know, in respect of skills, taking people on, one-on-ones, getting crosses in, fantastic. Coming back from such a bad injury, what she had, you know, she's hit the ground running, she's finished the season very well, and I think that she's a brilliant addition to the squad, coming off the bench. Hopefully she'll get some minutes so she can prove what she's capable of doing, but she is somebody that should be in this squad.
Yeah, I hope to see her at some point, second half, maybe 30 minutes, just so Serena can get a look at her. She's frightening when she gets the ball at her feet, taking players on. Her end product has been, before she got injured, it was really, really good. So hopefully she can add this to this England side. You know, she's a young player, aspiring player, and certainly one to look for coming off the bench.
Yeah. So Belgium, they're ranked 20th in the world. a little bit lower than England, obviously. Might represent a different kind of challenge to what we saw in the Arnold Clark Cup, but this is the team that they're starting out with tonight. Arguably, their two strongest players, their number nine, Tessa Woolart. She's ex-Man City striker. She's starting tonight. 65 goals for Belgium. She's their leading goal scorer in the World Cup qualifying campaign as well. And one name that we were quite surprised with missing off the list is Janice Kaiman. So she's a Champions League winner. She came off the bench against Barcelona for Lyon. She's very versatile. She's not in the squad. Apparently, she joined the squad yesterday. She's only trained with them once, so she's not quite ready. What do we think of this team and the threats that they pose, the ones that are playing with Tessa Woolart, for example?
Well, the thing is, Tessa Woolart, she is like, she's a record goal scorer. Like you said, she was at City. You know what I mean? She left to go back to Anderlecht. She scores a lot of goals, but let's face it, the standard is a lot lower. She wanted to go back. She wanted to be back with her family and stuff. She's happy doing that, but she can be dangerous. They are a team that, if they can get it into her, we'll have to see how well she can play at this level with this kind of calibre of player.
Yeah, she's certainly a key player for them. She'll hold the ball up, drop into the pockets. She's quick on the turn, will drive at Wuben Mooi and Millie Bright. She'll be a handful for them tonight. And she can turn and drive at players, so she's certainly a player to watch out for Belgium.
Excellent. This crowd in here will be very excited whatever happens tonight. 10,000, or over 10,000 in fact, expected at Molineux for the first of these three games that are going to predate the Euros later on this summer. After the break, we are going to hear from midfielder Georgia Stanway, who has her sights set high for this summer's Euros.
We want to try and inspire the next generation. We want to put smiles on people's faces. We want people to enjoy watching women's football. So we're just going to go out there, going to give it our all, and we're just going to try and do the nation proud.
The thing that's kept me on the straight and narrow 100% was boxing.
His rise to the top in the latest documentary in our Against the Odds series. Tony Bellew, punching above his weight, is on ITV4 next Wednesday at 9 p.m. Now, this is the third international that Molineux has staged in the space of 6 days. The England men's team played Italy and Hungary this week. They failed to score a single goal in either game. And now it's the Lionesses' turn. They're hoping to maybe score a couple of goals. And they're fully focused on their preparation for the Euros. Now, the last time the Lionesses played, they beat Northern Ireland 5-0. That was in a sold-out Windsor Park. They are now on the brink of qualifying the World Cup in 2023. All they need is a single point from their two remaining games where they take on Austria and Luxembourg. They're both in September. And that result, unfortunately for Northern Ireland, means they cannot make the playoffs. And on that night, midfielder Georgia Stanway, she scored two of England's goals. And since then, she's confirmed her move from Manchester City to Bayern Munich. Earlier on this week, she spoke to Katie Shanahan.
Georgia Stanway is someone who plays football with a smile. Charismatic and funny off the pitch, but a goal-scoring machine on it, with a CV dripped in silverware. And she's now ready to crank up the heat ahead of the Euros.
You've seen how the men were last year, the crowds that they got in, the bubble it created, literally lit up the nation. And that's just what we want to do. We want to try and inspire the next generation, put smiles on people's faces. We want people to enjoy watching women's football. So we're just going to go out there, give it our all, and we're just going to try and do the nation proud. We won the Arnold Clark and we won the She Believes, but when it comes to major tournaments, we've not gone there.
Why do you think that is?
I don't know, we've just fell short. We've got all the players, we've got all the attributes, but it's just about us now working on the grass, working tactical, technical, physical, to put ourselves together. We're just doing what we can, and we'll hopefully let the football do the talking.
Georgia's been eloquent on the pitch, becoming Manchester City's all-time women's goal scorer, reaching 63 goals. But after 7 years at City, it was time for a new challenge, a new life with German giants Bayern Munich.
I think the time was now to go and experience something different, a new opportunity, a different culture. I want to be rich in life. I want to experience everything. I want to just kind of be the best that I can be as a person and as a player and buying with a team that massively, massively impressed me. And you never know what a new manager, a new environment can do for you. The way that the Germans play, it's strict, it's disciplined, it's physicality as well as technical and tactical. I just felt that was where I could be at my best.
This is a player who thrives as an attacking midfield. Yet her career has seen her play everywhere, including between the sticks. So does she still want this versatility tag?
Brutally honest, I don't want it. That was partly the reason that I wanted to go somewhere else. I feel at Manchester City the past 18 months have been quite difficult for me because I've not really been able to establish a position. Been right back, left back, different parts of the midfield, wing. I was just slotting in where people were being injured. I felt like I was plateauing and I felt like I was just at a standstill. And that's not what I wanted. I want to be able to establish myself in a position. And when I come to the likes of England, I come in as a number 8 and as a number 10. And Bayern were able to offer me that opportunity to knuckle down on them positions and just try and be the best that I can in them. And you never know what could happen.
Right, we're going to test your knowledge on Germany. You ready?
Yep, I'm ready.
What is the population of Germany?
600 million.
No, not quite. Oh. It's 83 million.
Oh.
What a save!
I'm the worst at this.
What is the capital of Germany?
Berlin.
Yes, correct.
Yes!
What is Germany in German?
Deutschland.
Correct.
Yes, touch finish.
Where is Munich in the country?
South.
Yes. Oh. Finally, how do you spell Borussia Mönchengladbach?
B-O-R...
Yep.
I-S-S-A...
U-S-S-I.
U-S-S-A... So, I really don't know my German.
Right, well played.
Well played.
Luckily, she's got a few months to swat up on her German ahead of a very busy summer.
I'm smiling, the rest of the girls are smiling. We're just excited now. This is our third week in training camp. I think we've got 2 more weeks to go and then the real action starts.
Do you think this England team can go all the way?
We'll see.
Well, Georgia might be pleasantly surprised when she gets to Germany and realises it's not grossly overpopulated. She might have a great time there. She's made a big decision, Kelly, and when you listen to her speak about it, I think a really mature decision.
Yeah.
It's not a path well trodden, is it, from England to Germany? What do you think is the right move for her?
It's a very honest, an open interview that she just gave. You know, she said it was frustrating for her being not playing in her regular position, and that was due to the fact that Manchester City had 10 players out injured the early part of the season, so they had to shuffle it around. And she's in a point in her career now where she wants to play in a normal position, in the 8 or the 10, where she feels her best strengths are. I was a little bit surprised to see her move to Germany. Most players go to America or to Sweden, so... I wish her all the best. I think she's a fantastic player and she needs to now solidify her position and grow in that position.
And that's what she said, yeah. That's what she said she wanted to do. And when you've got to understand is that we're dealing with a generation of girls who... professional football wasn't even an option. It didn't even know it was going to be an option. So for her to be able to have the choice to be able to go to somewhere like Bayern Munich, get a position that she's going to be good in and make a real start so she could come into this England side in the position she's playing her best football in. And if she has to go to Germany to get that, she's willing to do that. And I think that is brilliant. You see the young guys in the male game go and do it. It's brilliant to see the ladies go and do it as well.
We're seeing some of it now, Kelly. Just tell us what the strengths are, what she brings to this England side.
Just her runs from deep. You'll see this clip here, the audacity just to do this. She chests the ball down and it's kind of a sidekick or overhead kick. You know, she's so creative when she gets on the ball. She's strong in her running. She can see a final pass, the accuracy on the pass. She shoots from long distance when keepers aren't expecting it. And she's just a brilliant player for club and country. And every time she gives 100%.
She speaks about the importance of wanting to nail down that number 8 role and having someone like Serena that understands that and actually gets the best out of her. How important is that from a manager?
It's very important because then if she can play in a position she's happiest in, she's going to play her best football. She's going to be happy about it. To go into a game, know that I can do what I want to do, you know, my skills, what I can give to the team. To be able to go out there and know you're going to be able to do that is only going to make you play better. So to get a manager that's giving you that opportunity because you didn't get it at City, then hopefully her playing today, she can start doing that and playing as well as we know that she can.
Absolutely. OK, it's building up nicely here, isn't it? It's been a beautiful day from Wolverhampton. Don't go anywhere because after the break, we are going to continue this build-up to England against Belgium. In the 12 times they've met, the Lionesses have only lost once, and that was over 40 years ago. Is that a good omen? We will find out soon. They're up at 9 a.m. Hopefully, some more sunshine. Well, last Sunday, the manager of WSL champions Chelsea was pitchside at Soccer Aid for the England team. And tonight, delighted to say, she's joining us in commentary. A big hello to Emma Hayes. Thanks for joining us, Emma.
Hi, Laura. How are you?
Very well, thank you. You've switched all these celebrities and you're back doing the proper business here with the Lionesses. First of all, everyone in the studio have had their say. What do you think of the final 23 women's squad?
I think it's got good balance. I think the mixture of youth, experience, you know, players I think have had big seasons in WSL. I think she's got it right, and you know, it's always disappointing when players miss out, but I think it's a very balanced group she's put together.
I bet you're delighted to see Frank Kirby in there as well.
You know what, she's worked really hard, and I think real credit to Serena and her backroom staff. I think they've managed her perfectly. I've always been really adamant that to get Fran to her best levels, how we manage her at England, I think is going to be instrumental. So it's crucial that she's ready, and hopefully she gets some minutes tonight.
Kelly's alongside me as well, Emma. We were speaking earlier on about other players that are really important for this England side. And you said Lauren Hemp might be vital.
Oh, she's electrifying when she gets the ball. She gets people off her seats. You know, she's faster running with the ball, dribbling, than most players are when they're running beside her. It's hard to keep up with her, but she's so talented. When she gets the ball at her feet, she makes things happen for this England side and Manchester City side. She glances past people with ease and creates chance after chance. And her goal tally this year has been extremely good. Just when she cuts in here on her left foot, she makes things happen, always looking to get into the box. She's just a live wire, and it's a beautiful finish there with her head. Here, you know, she just glides past players, and then obviously brilliant shot from outside the box. She gives this England team something different. In a couple of years, for me, she will be a world-class player. What player of the year?
I think so. She's somebody that, when you look at her, the ceiling she's got is unbelievable. What they've got to do, you've got to stop her from going inside. You've got to get her outside, because if she cuts inside, she's going to beat you. She's got the kind of ability that she could probably play in any top team in the world at the moment. And at 21, you look at her at 21, and it's only like Vivian Miedema, 25, and Sam Kerr, 28, who have got more goals and assists than her at 21. So her ceiling is way up there. So what she's capable of doing is time will tell.
Young player of the year for a reason, obviously, Emma. Do you agree with these guys? Could she have a massive summer?
I mean, she's unstoppable. She really is. I've always felt when coaching against her, the best you can do is minimise the impact, because she's that devastating. I agree with Wrighty, you have to keep her on the outside. But that being said, she still crosses most balls into the area than any other player in the WSL. So she's dangerous out there, but she's most dangerous, I think, when she gets on the inside. Top, top player.
Emma, three games now before the Lionesses go to the Euros, or the Euros come to the Lionesses in this country. What do you want to see from these three games, from those players?
I think it's a perfect build. I think it's a great opportunity for players coming into the team, because there will be some that are missing due to recovering from COVID, or, you know, just little injuries that they don't want to take into the tournament. So I think tonight it'd be interesting to see the midfield three, see how they work. I think Stanway has got huge potential for this tournament, and knowing that Fran Kirby's on the bench to make an impact. England certainly have a lot of attacking qualities that I think they've got to maximise.
All right, Emma, thank you. We look forward to listening to you in commentary. Enjoy the game. Now, it was two games for the England men's side this week, and now it is time for the Lionesses to step up and try and score a goal at least here at Molineux. Join us after the break when the teams will be coming out. Just 20 days away from the start of the Euros in this country. It's not just the Lionesses who are excited, it's all of these fans that have turned out here to Molineux today. Over 10,000 expected. We opened the doors earlier on, it's filling up nicely, and the atmosphere is absolutely wonderful. Why don't we hear from the Lionesses captain now? Leah Williamson is with Katie Shanahan.
Leah, 20 days to go. How proud are you to be leading England out ahead of a home Euros?
Yeah, it all feels very real now. Couldn't be more proud, and yeah, it's what dreams are made of, to be in the squad. But obviously with that extra responsibility, it's a very proud moment for me and my family. Yeah.
How did you and the team find out that you've been selected for the Euros?
Serena's wanted it to be very personable and had one-to-ones with every player, so contrast to the emails that we would have received in the past and stuff like that. So yeah, everybody got a personal meeting and received the news that way.
Have you spoken to Steph Horton yet?
I haven't caught up with Steph just yet, but as a team, you know, the girls are obviously feeling the pain that she'll be feeling, and she will be missed. You know, it's football and decisions have to be made, but for us, Steph is one of the greatest role models and one of the most professional people I've ever met. So yeah, I'm sure when I do speak to her, you know, give her some time and hope that she'll want to be a part of this as much as possible.
And I believe Princess Charlotte told her father, the Duke of Cambridge, to let you know that she's really good in goal.
She did,
so
yeah.
You're going to give her a go then, potentially sometime in the future?
Yeah, get her in for a training session and see how she fares up, yeah.
I'm sure they'll hold you to that. Good yeah. Night tonight, Leah.
Thank you, thanks. All right.
And it's good to know that Princess Charlotte is actually quite good at football, because apparently her dad went to St George's Park, put on his boots, or didn't put on his boots, had a little go and wasn't very good. And Serena Beeming was a little bit, I think, kind to him and said, look, it's obviously the wrong footwear.
I did see the clips. His technique was okay, to be fair, but he didn't have football boots on, so he slipped a little bit at the end.
Yeah, it is difficult.
It's fair enough.
Give him a fly on that one.
Fair enough. It's always great to hear Leah speaking, isn't it? And I think she's taken on this role of captain so well. She speaks very maturely.
Yeah.
This could be a huge summer for her too, Ian.
Well, it will be, because like she's been given the role of captain, and it's a big, big role. And that's why it would have been interesting if Steph was still in and around her, how she would be able to develop in that role, especially as she's got players around her in Jill Scott, in Ellen White, in Lucy Bronze. So she's very mature. She looks like she's very much ready for it. And I think Serena's made the decision because she's seen all those attributes in her.
Is there a way? I mean, the team was only announced yesterday, and we know that this is because of a family bereavement for Serena Wiegmann, which, of course, all of our thoughts go to Serena's family.
Yeah.
It means the squad was delayed. It was supposed to come out last Monday. How, Ian, does that affect a team? Does it affect it in a way?
Well, when you do that the day before the game, which I've never been known to happen, your mind's normally on the game, what's going to be coming. So to be in a squad where you're hoping that you're going to be in it and your mind's somewhere else, and then all the euphoria, all the disappointment, and then the disappointment for the other players, and then you've got to get yourself ready to go for a game. It's not the kind of preparation you're used to, but hopefully we start well, because if we don't, I think Belgium can cause us some problems.
Yeah, I think in 2019, the teams played each other. It was 3-3, and Belgium were down to 2-0. So they have something about them versus this Belgian side. So like rightly said, it's about how we start. Do you know what? For me, the nerves are now off these England players because they're in the squad. They know what they've got to do now. Now they're thinking, right, I'm in the 23, but now I want to go and play well tonight and put my mind in Serena's mind, and I want to start. I want to start every game. That's where it's got to come from now.
And these are the kind of games, it's a very good game for us, because we are better than them, but we have to prove it. These are the kind of games you really want to make an impression on the manager. Really put something in her mind so she says, right, I'm going to keep an eye on her.
You've seen as well, we saw the men's team play.
Yeah.
We saw them underperform to what we know that they can actually perform for. Perhaps they were tired from the season.
They were tired from the season.
Do you expect any of that? Could this happen to the Lionesses?
I don't think so.
Why?
Why
is it different?
Obviously, they haven't got the same kind of schedule. The amount of games that they're playing. I don't think that a lot. I'm not looking at any of those nations' games, because I don't even think we should have been involved with it. He should have used a whole different team and take the pressure off himself. But I don't think the ladies will be as tired. I think they'll be ready to go. They know they're in the squad now. It's all ready to go for the Euros. And I think that they'll be very much ready to go. It won't be tiredness from their point of view at all.
It's all about excitement now, going out and performing, like I said. This is what you want, these three build-up games. Nice warm-up games to put yourself in front of the manager's mind.
Yeah.
It's a big tournament coming up, and they're going to lap it up. I've been here. I played in the 2005 Euros in England. It's just a phenomenal feeling to walk out like this with your home crowd in a Euros, thousands watching you. Absolutely brilliant.
Excellent. We cannot wait for this one. Serena Wiegmann has three games left ahead of the Euros. Belgium provide the test tonight. And to talk us through this match will be Emma Hayes. But first, Seb Hutchinson.
England are back in the Black Country. Forget Hungary, this was the scene of that historic home win over Germany in February, and the stage again for the first of three scene setters ahead of the home Euros. Plenty in attendance tonight at Molineux. It's England against Belgium, and the anthems first up.
Thank you.
England against Belgium, and all the action after this short break. For England, the first of three meetings with sides ranked in the world's top 20, but the Arnold Clark Cup already showed this year the higher level opposition may not be as much of a stumbling block under the new boss. An empathic touch from the England players to their manager. The Lionesses wearing black armbands in remembrance of Serena Wiegmann's sister, who passed away during this international camp. And Leah Williamson, the new England captain, wearing the rainbow armband in support of Pride Month. Game number 12 of the new reign, and the Lionesses still yet to lose. And they'll expect to beat Belgium tonight as well. Referee Sara Pearson from Sweden, as are all the officials. Will be Lauren Hemp to get England underway. But both sets of players set to take the knee. Take the knee, Belgium take the knee. The men's and women's sides still taking the stand against all forms of discrimination. So away we go, a run of friendlies to see how Serena Wiegmann's side is shaping up ahead of what we hope will be an excellent summer of football. And Emma, what are you hoping to get from these friendly matches?
I think we have to bear in mind that a lot of these players haven't played a game of football for several weeks, and they've been in training camp. So every player will be looking forward to the opportunity to impress their manager, and most importantly, putting across the things that they're working on in training.
And England already looking to put pressure on Belgium in the opening seconds of the game. It must be remembered that Belgium themselves have also qualified for the European Championships. They'll be in a group with Iceland, France and Italy. Here's Lucy Bronze, without a club at the moment, but not for much longer. Walsh. Otto Vibbermoy, second start for her. And an eighth overall. Here's Bright. To Bronze. Break forward already, England causing problems. Big break from Williamson from midfield. Those raiding runs from the usual Arsenal defender.
It's what they're going to need if Walsh is going to sit a little bit deeper. Can't leave that solely to Stanway in the 10 position. And Leah is certainly capable of doing that.
It's Nicky Evrard. Current number one for Belgium. Didn't start their qualification campaign as the number one, though. Very experienced. Davina Filchens, over 100 caps, one of two centurions. In this Belgium side, they're without Hannes Kaiman, who only joined up with the squad yesterday. Two-time Champions League winner, most recently with Lyon. Sari Kaes. Deluza can play on either side of defence for Belgium. Some experienced players in this team, but also some with not too many caps in this side. Sara Vernant's playing on the right-hand side, but she usually can operate on the left. Stanway, a close eye on her in this side, that number 10 position for England. Now Millie Bright, one of England's best players in the past year. Vermoy. Stokes. Stanway to Walsh. Bright to Lucy Bronze, where she likes to operate. Mead, Bronze, nicely worked move from England. Scramble defence from Belgium in the end, and the danger averted from their point of view.
Oh, good play from England. You can see already how high Lucy Bronze is. in the picture, almost playing as a right winger so that Beth Mead can come on the inside.
England not going to make it easy for Belgium to try and pass the ball out. There's Minnaert. De Neva, who takes set pieces as well, the centre-half. That ball did just go out of play, which probably was a blessing for Belgium because Hemp had the ball in a bit of space. Yves Senils, who's been in charge for 11 years, long-serving coach, has taken Belgium to just their second ever major tournament. They were in the last Euros in 2017, a tournament won, of course, by Serena Wiegmann and her Netherlands side. Can she go back-to-back for two different nations?
What I do think she has the opportunity to do tonight is to work on the pressing game, because Belgium are looking to build out in every situation.
Vilchens playing that down the line. Minnaert is chasing, but she was offside in the end. One of those that plays her football in Belgium. Brugge, or Brugge as they call it there.
You can see already, though, Belgium have players high on the line. You can see clearly offside.
Here is Millie Bright, who made her debut for England in Belgium in 2016. Firm fixture in this lineup. Here's Stokes. Now Wimmer Moy. Three Arsenal players in this lineup. Williamson. Now Bronze, who already is raiding down that right-hand side and surging away from challenges, and there's plenty in the penalty area for England. But mishit the cross in the end, but that's a bit more like the Lucy Bronze we know.
But it makes sense. You've got Williamson dropping out of midfield into that false fullback position to get on the ball. It then allows Bronze to combine effectively with Mead. And this is what we're used to seeing, good 1v1 play. Just lack the quality with the end product.
Just waiting for her to reveal where she's going to be playing this coming season. Here's Mary Earps. Feels like the undisputed number one for England between the sticks. Although it has to be said, she hasn't had much to do in an England shirt. This has been England's domination in the World Cup qualification campaign.
One thing I think they do have to address, and the real issues for England against better opposition, has been their build-up.
Here is Bright starting their latest build-up. All towards Ellen White. Too many touches of the ball so far. And then Mead got away from Viljoens, who's having a difficult time in these early stages, the experienced fullback.
England doing a good job just overloading down their right-hand side. It's late.
Viljoens made her debut for Belgium back in 2008. Plays in Italy for Sassuolo. Here is Mary Earps, well out of her goal to help England build up. Moy. Towards Stanway. Here's Walsh. Bright looking for that switch across to Hemp. First chance for Hemp to run with the ball. Quickly closed down. Hemp again, a bit of a loose touch. A rare loose touch.
That's what you will get with Millie Bright. It's the same with Alex Greenwood when she plays. That ability to switch the big balls. Open the pitch up.
Already looks as though two Belgian shirts are trying to get close to Hemp at all times. Might need more than that. Here's Bright. Bronze to Mead. Here is Beth Mead, one of the standout players in the WSL this season and for England. Just lost her footing there. Vernant's back and the loser under pressure. And no foul, and picked up by Hemp. And Hemp pulls it back, and time for Stanway. Radar is off.
This is what I think England are really good at. Pressure on the backward ball. you can see Hemp does so well, some might argue it was a foul. But Stanway, I thought the weight of the pass from Hemp, perhaps she could have hit it first time. They're the position Stanway wants to be in. And Lauren Hemp, as we know, brilliant in those areas.
Belgium trying to pass out under pressure again. Harem scarem stuff here from the away side, but Willard calms things down. Just nice touch from Vernon. Willard, a danger player for Belgium. Trying to prod that forward. And composure from Williamson. Who felt she was fouled, but England retained the ball anyway.
Well, that's what you do get with Williamson in midfield. Just that natural defensive instinct.
As we're also seeing, she has to carry the ball forward as well. There's Delacau. Neat footwork from the young midfielder. Minard sends it in, and they've got height in that penalty area, Belgium. Just evaded to Kenny. Stokes can't hold on to it. Vernants. Aided in away by Ruben Moy. And here's Ellen White. Demi Stokes changing her mind there. And again, this is a bit awkward for England.
But as I mentioned earlier, this is the area of their play they have to improve at. When they're under pressure, deep inside their own half, how to solve it.
Moy. Stokes has a bit of room. Moy finds Stokes. She plays it in to Hemp. Now Walsh. Walsh looking for bronze. One of her many Manchester City teammates. Or was until recently. Minard. Lost by Delacau. Can England punish him? Smart stop by Evrard. England keeping that ball in play, but Ellen White came so close there. Stanway.
In the Arnold Cup, England made more ball recoveries than Germany and Canada. This is a real strength of the England team. And as we saw from that passage of play, brilliant ball recovery and great opportunity for Ellen White.
It won't be the last for England where they've started this game. Ruben Moy into White. Walsh. Williamson. Stanway. Stokes. Stanway followed all the way. Julie Beastman's at the moment. Bright and bronze, heavy touch, invited the challenge from Minard, who's had a lot of touches so far.
You can see in the way Belgium have set up, they're happy to let both of England's centre-backs have the ball and play out to the full-backs.
Ellen White going so close there. Here's Stokes. Versus England have come, either side have come. Kenny losing the ball. Ruben Moy.
But notice with Ruben Moy, she can't find Kira Walsh easily because the way they're defending Belgium in the 4-4-2, they're just pivoting off of Walsh. So England are going to have to solve ways to get her on the ball.
Bright goes straight towards White. Bronze. And now Meade, nobody's there though. Belgium settling defensively. Walsh, Williamson. Front foot start from her. Now bronze. Linking up with Stanway. Bronze, Stanway. Williamson. Stanway again onto Walsh. We'll work it to the left and Stokes. Vermooy into Williamson. Allowed time to turn, pick the pass to Hemp. And Hemp keeping that ball under her spell. Lauren Hemp went for the near post. Keeper pushes it wide, but a chance for Hemp.
But much better play from England in general, much more indirect, starting down that right-hand side. Allowed Williamson to get on the ball and spray it into Hemp's path. Once she got into this area, I think everybody thought she was going to the far post. I think that extra touch just took it away from her.
England knocking on the door, though. This first quarter of an hour. In goes the corner, just evades. It's Williamson attacking that one. Corner from Mead. Hutchins gets the decision there for Belgium. We're under pressure early on. Here's White. Williamson.
I think it's the perfect game for England to work at their patience in the final third. I think that chance was created as a result of it, getting Stanway involved out in the wider spaces.
And White made something out of that ball. They can still have it.
I think one of the pressures they're going to face this summer, especially with a home crowd, is if they don't score early. So I think it's important for England to find their rhythm without worrying about the crowd one way or the other.
It's Bronze. Now, Vermooy carries that ball forward. Stokes. She'll have a run. And Stokes gets away from one challenge. Stokes again, Walsh. England being patient this time. Williamson. Bright. And here's Hemp. Inside to Bronze. Back to Hemp. Three waiting for the cross. Bronze digs out that cross and White will go for it. Did she get there first?
Again, good patient play. Hemp, Bronze involved. Lofted ball. You see White got a head to it first. I felt it could have taken a few more passes. I didn't feel the cross needed to go in at that point. And I do see the development under Wiegmann of England's patient play in the final third. And I think against top opposition, we're going to be organised. And this is one area of our game we've had to improve in.
So far, so good. Here's Williamson. Oops. Vermooy out to Hemp. Straight away, one thought in her mind to drift inside and slip a pass towards White. Might break here for Williamson, who's everywhere at the moment. Putting that pressure on as well.
Well, what we're seeing for England is rotation across the front. We've seen Hemp go on that right-hand side and Mead to the left. Williamson playing higher than Kira Walsh to get involved in behind Ellen White. As I mentioned before, Kira Walsh not involved in the game because of the way Belgium are set up. I think she's crucial for England. They've got to get her on the ball a little more.
Headed from Vermooy. Walsh tidying that one up. For the last 3 years or so, Kira Walsh has been the base of that England midfield as a single player, getting some help in that area. You would say much overdue, but at the moment, not much help at the base of it as it stands.
She's got the ability to hit longer balls. One of the best in the league. Completion rate of about 72%.
Musa trying to slip that through to Woolard. Vernens. De La Cow. Belgium looking to keep the ball for a bit. Currently second in their World Cup qualification group to Norway. Only 3 points behind them, and they still have to play the Norwegians again. The Norwegians were much the better side when the two teams met earlier in that campaign. Runner-up in the group would go into a World Cup playoff. It's not all hope lost for a third major tournament for Belgium. On the attack here, Minard tucking a shirt from Stanway. And a free kick in the end.
The thing here with Belgium is while they struggle a little in their build-up, they absolutely have a goal-scoring threat.
We say England beat Latvia 20-0. Belgium beat Armenia 19-0 before that.
Then when they face Spain, they have to deal with 28 shots against. I think it's a team that knows against the top sides, they're going to concede possession. They certainly create chances, even against the best teams.
The last time these two countries met, a 3-3 draw in 2019. Belgium, no pushovers by any means. The last side to score. Competitive game in England. Bright. De La Cow. Bit more ball though here for Belgium.
I think they're growing in the game. One thing they're doing is shutting off that central corridor for England to play in. So much of England's play is to leave the two centre backs possession and force to the fullbacks.
As you said, Emma, Serena will be probably slightly pleased about this sort of scenario, that this sort of challenge that Belgium are posing. Not if they score, though. Here's Vernens. Belgium have a player down, but they're on the attack anyway. Woolard and Stokes finds the time and plays it out calmly to Williamson, but the game will be stopped now.
Belgium do have with a player like Woolard is somebody who drops into the pocket and links up with everyone. And you saw just in that last passage, she can drive forward at the back four. Looks like she just caught a trailing leg.
Yes, Julie Wiesmans is down. Spent two seasons in the WSL with Bristol City. She's played against a lot of these England players before in club football. And in the middle there, with her hair down, second from the left, Janice Kaiman, who's probably Belgium's standout player, the two-time Champions League winner. Was recently with Lyon in that brilliant victory over Barcelona and Turin. She's unavailable tonight because she only joined up with the team yesterday. And next to her, Manava Matt, who plays for Reading in the WSL. She's unavailable with a minor injury. She'll be back for the remaining friendlies that Belgium have. It's Northern Ireland and Austria, who incidentally are the two of the sides that England face at the Euros, and two of the sides who they've already faced in World Cup qualification. Beesmans, we'll see if she's able to continue. But England, the better side in these opening 20 minutes, Emma. And what about Georgia Stanway making this move to Bayern Munich and all this talk about who should play in that 10 role?
Listen, I always admire players that push themselves, that test themselves. So good luck to her on that move. I think with regards to the 10 position, from what I'm watching right now, is England can't get their midfield on the ball. And if you can't get your midfield on the ball, you're not going to get your 10 involved. And what you will start to see, I suspect, is Stanway coming a little lower to get on it, which means that she might be isolated from Ellen White. So I think it's critical in these moments in the game, you just have to keep probing, keep sticking to the game plan.
Bright going for probably the most effective game plan for England. Get it to Hemp. And Hemp sends it in towards White, and Everard collects the ball.
But that is what England are going to have to do if there isn't any pressure on the centre-backs. I mean, Millie Bright has the ability to do that. I think when Hemp gets into those areas, as we know, everybody expects her to go 1v1. But with a player like Ellen White in the box, she's got a player that's looking for service.
Here's a bit of space for Minna. Now Woolart. Dekani making a run into the penalty area. Woolart will look for her. Away by Bright. They do have height in that penalty area, Belgium. And Millie Bright will have to rise to that challenge, and we know she can.
I think Belgium have adapted well to the game. I think they're growing into it. They're finding spaces in the midfield.
We just saw a brief shot there of the armband of Tessa Woolart as well. So wearing it, recognition of Pride Month. Here's Mary Earps. I mentioned Stanway. Mary Earps, one of the few England players who've played in Germany. For a German club, I should say, in Wolfsburg. Now Bright. Into Mead. And Bronze trying to up the tempo there, England. Here's Mead again. And White putting the pressure on the neighbour. White playing it back. Belgium can get out of trouble.
Well, they have to, because so far England's best chances are coming from those ball recoveries. Cheap turnover. There is one player I think that is critical for England's success this summer, and that's Beth Mead. She's had a crucial season in the WSL, and she led the league in XG assist with 7.7. I mean, that's prolific. Exceptional year for her.
Here's Bright. Now Bronze. Can Stanway get there first? She can. Stanway is opened up for her nicely. Stanway wide. He thought for all the world the net would bulge, but it didn't for Georgia Stanway.
Well, that was the first time I'd seen the Belgian midfield defence just open up. I think Bronze thought she'd overhit it initially. Good inside running from Stanway, and many times we've seen her in these positions and put the ball in the back of the net.
Belgium forced to go long. Dekani, who can't really get in the game at the moment. Bright. Now Walsh. Looking it out to Mead. Tried to force it on there, Beth Mead. Who's on that right-hand side for England. May have some pressure. Other members of the squad in that particular position. And that's pushed out wide. Took a blow there, Stanway, but England going on with Stokes. And still Stokes. Hemp. With a Moy. Stanway back to her feet. Bright, all the outfield players in the Belgium half. Feels like when Belgium are set defensively, difficult to break down. Here's Mead. As you said several times already, Emma, England need this sort of challenge.
And patience. You have to work the opponent. You know, the two centre midfielders for Belgium will get stretched eventually. They have to work them down.
Hemp, nice feet. Stanway, they're working it on. Williamson took a little nick. It should be a corner.
You can see the last 2-3 minutes, space is starting to open up for Stanway in particular. because Beesman in particular is having to do a lot of running in that central midfield area. She can't cover the central areas as well as she can the inner corridors.
She took that knock as well. How much that's affecting her, but at the moment, England still probing for that opening goal. Only half an hour played. Bright, Vermoy up for this corner. Two centre-backs, and Bright is free and helps it on, and surely no. Ellen White couldn't force it home.
Certainly thought it was going to go in. You see, Millie Bright doesn't quite catch it. It falls perfectly for Ellen White, just rushes the shot.
And again, Belgium trying to pass out from the back, but can't deal with England's pressure. Ellen White, at the moment, 50 goals for her country. Quite the return, one in two. It won't be her last. Ever with Harry Kane at the moment.
I mean, just an unbelievable record for England, it really is.
That's why there's no doubt she was going to be in this squad. Here's Bronze. Bronze driving and hanging it in there towards wide. Everard pushes it away. Delacau clears that calmly away. And then Bright tried to win that ball aggressively and did just about in the end, helped out by Bronze.
And it's a good moment in the game for England. You see they're pushing for the opener.
White onto Stanway. Good urgency. Hemp towards White, beaten to it by Delacau, who's going to cover back there for Belgium, dropping more of their midfielders to deeper areas to try and deal with England here. But here's Walsh. Hemp. Direct Hemp, keeping that ball close to her foot. In it goes, hung in there by Bronze. Surely this time for Mead to get a shot away, but couldn't hit the targets.
Well, again, you're seeing the rotation between Mead and Hemp. You see the danger of Hemp cutting in on her left from the right-hand side, and Mead, this is where she's been brilliant all year. Just snatches it.
Beth Mead on that right-hand side. But finding herself in central area there. Excellent goal return for England during the qualification campaign. Four goals in their last trip to North Macedonia. The Neva.
The thing is with Mead, everybody looks at her as a top goal scorer, but her and Fran Kirby were first and second for key passes in the WSL, and she's crucial to assist for any England player.
Bukani, Renance, play the ball in with either foot. That wasn't the best pass though for the wide player. And Stanway back to Mary Earps. Manchester United side just missed out on Champions League football, as Manchester City had a very strong second half of the season. Here's Millie Bright for the champions, Chelsea. Bronze. Room to run into. And space for Lucy Bronze. Can she pick the right pass? Back it goes to Williamson. Probably not the right pass. And Belgium, can they launch a positive attack here? Willard. Right it goes now, and Schurz getting into that penalty area. And Minard plays it in, and that's a big chance. A free chance for Delacau. Should have done better.
That's exactly where I think England are most vulnerable, when they commit both fullbacks like they did. You see Bronze having to back recover. Just one player on the edge of the box. It's a massive overload. England will be disappointed with the way they defended that. But they're the vulnerabilities when you play with high and wide fullbacks, as those spaces either side of the centre-backs are massively open for the counter-attack.
Feli Delacau with that big chance for Belgium. Just her sixth cap. bronze. Reigning forward again. Mead. Beth Mead. Everard pushes it away. Stokes. Stanway trying to force that out to Hemp. Commitment there from Willard. Ex-Manchester City teammate in Walsh. Walsh to Bronze. Bronze, clever ball to Mead. Shot blocked. Stokes helps it in there towards Mead. And it might break to her again. Looking towards the referee. England, no penalty.
I'm surprised by that. My initial reaction from up here was penalty. Yeah, I think so. Having looked at it twice, you can just see Beth Mead gets her body in between the player and the ball.
Here's White. That's going to be free kick right on the edge of the area. Helen White winning that free kick. I think for Delacour a moment earlier, missed that big chance. Should have conceded a penalty. An interesting minute for the youngster, but an interesting position here for England.
Well, good response from England. Should have potentially gone 1-0 down with that swift counter-attack, but reacted immediately. And as we've seen throughout the qualifying campaign, very prolific from set pieces.
Lauren Hemp to take. Hangs it in there towards the back post. Haven't cleared their lines effectively. Got the block in that time though. Here's Stokes. Now Bright. She sends it in towards White. Asking a lot there, but it makes its way to Hemp. And Hemp, first thought, take on your player. Wins the corner.
So easy to say, you know what she's going to do. It's so difficult to stop her. She's so good at that. Gets the ball down. Her ability to change speed from a standing position is better than almost anyone I've ever seen.
Mead with this corner for England. It's a low one that should be dealt with by Belgium. White almost got there. It's into the arms. Lucky Everard in any case.
England need just to take their time with the set pieces. They've rushed the last two. It's an important area for them.
Chloe Kelly recently returned from injury and in her first squad under Serena Wiegmann. Big competition for Beth Mead on that right hand side. Interesting development. Very talented young player. Neighbour inside. Willard. Just in between two teammates there, Willard. It's briefly promising for Belgium. Here's Bronze driving forward, and that she was fouled there. And I think Beesmans is a bit fortunate to escape a booking there.
Yeah, cynical play. Had to do it though, that part of the pitch. And Bronze certainly finding this part of her game improving. I think she's playing more and more games over the season. This is what she will give England. That ability to burst in transition, join the attack.
Well, in that last meeting, that 3-3 in 2019, Lucy Bronze was playing centre midfield that day.
The thing is, she gives the team so much in attack, but I think that England are going to be vulnerable down that side if they don't get the balance right.
Here's Walsh. Hemp. Been on the right and the left. Always a threat. Mead plays it back inside, linking up well. Williamson, lovely dink, but the cover on the line was there from Case.
England are doing everything but put the ball in the back of the net. I mean, again, really, really good combination play. I think once Williamson was in behind, she made the right decision, just didn't have the right amount of pace.
And that was a risky ball to play across your own box. Deneva, but Kay's worked out of trouble, worked Belgium out of a problem again. And Deluza went down, straight back up now, and there's space here for Mead, but Walsh couldn't find her. White. Minard. Belgium's better players in this first half. Driving forward as well. De Cani. Dangerous player as well for Belgium. Minard. Good pass. Here's Mead. Walsh. Always tidy. Hemp.
I think Belgium have done well at times to get into England's, around England's penalty area, but it's the last pass that has let them down.
I feel like they've offered just about enough though to not make this so comfortable for England. Here's Stokes.
And that's why it's the perfect test. It's the last thing you want. Something that's too comfortable. Serena will want the challenges from this game, see how she can keep improving the team.
Williamson. Hemp. Off she goes. Couldn't find Stanway. Feel like it's guaranteed she's going to beat the first defender every time. There's Willard. And that's a good ball. Balance. Willard. Belgium captain. Looking for that pass. Looking for Deluzo, who had made a run forward from right back. And England deal with it. But Leah Williamson with that excellent opportunity and almost a lovely finish.
You can see that combination. Williamson, Mead, Bronze. I think she did everything right. Lifted it. Just not enough pace on it. Perhaps she could have took the shot a little earlier in the near post.
Reminded me of her first goal in the WSL for Arsenal a long time ago now. A little dink that one was as well against Chelsea.
She's such a good player. She honestly, I think she could play any position across the back four, plus any of the midfield positions.
Had a bright first half as well and has really taken on this leadership role.
There's going to be a lot of responsibility on her. She's still a youngish player. Going to need the experience in the camp around her to help her.
A fair number of this squad have never been at a major tournament. Williamson was part of the squad in 2019. It's the semi-finals to the United States. There's Walsh, who was in that England team. Stokes. With Moy. Bright. Williamson. Bronze. And having to be patient again. They've created plenty of chances in this first half. Just looking to take one now. Before half time. Here's Stokes. Now Mead. With Bemoy looking for Stanway, not far off with that pass. But again, it's down to the centre-backs to play that decisive ball.
Yeah, it's when it gets congested. You're playing against a block of 4-4-1-1. There's not a lot of central area space and you can't get your centre midfielders on the ball. That's going to be England's challenge.
Dukani trying to help that ball on. There's Minard again and getting it back once more. Working it out to Vernance. Could she do? I want to get it onto her left. Tries to go down the line. And Demi Stokes deals with it.
Again, good play by Minard. She reminds me of a young Jill Scott. The way she's marauding through midfield. She's been involved in everything, much in the same way Woolart has. And they've offered a threat.
Certainly have in this first half, and they've had chances. One bigger than that big chance for Lady Delacau. Probably should have conceded a penalty moments after. Bubamoy looking for White, is going to break to Mead. Stokes. Here's Walsh. Vermoy. Belgium, the lowest ranked of the three sides England played before the Euros. As I've said before, not one of the weaker sides in Europe, that's for sure. Placements back to Everard. Case, the goal line clearance. Starry Case. Deluza. Confident play here from Belgium. Willard getting involved in the build-up as well. England, Arnold Clark Cup winners in February, but so early this year, Belgium winning their own invitational tournament, beating Wales along the way. Here is Everard. The longest run of possession in the whole half. Delacau, Willard. Growing in confidence with this attack. Vernance. Stone Vernance teasing, Stone twisting. Vernance keeping the move alive. Getting it back and going for goal. Well, that's well over in the end. But good period of play for Belgium.
Oh, absolutely. I think they've contributed massively in the first half. I think every time they get inside or around the penalty box, that's where they've lacked the quality.
Just 2 minutes to be added on. And a busy first half, but no goal so far. With the Moy. Now Stokes. Was dealt with by Case. Well, he'll be happy so far, the Belgian manager. Be getting that ball back to Demi Stokes. Side holding out against one of the favourites for the Euros. Serena Wiegmann, plenty to think about as well at halftime, but she won't mind that. Here's Hemp. And still Hemp. Stanway. Walsh. Looking for Mead. Does find Mead. And a chance for Mead to shoot as well. And going on, and just ran out of space in the end. It will be a corner.
It's just that indecision inside the penalty box. Does the first part really well, gets the ball down, gets in front. She doesn't know if there's enough of a shooting opportunity early, so decides to take it round. It's just one touch too many inside the penalty area. And that last-ditch defending, emergency defending by Belgium has been exceptional the whole half.
So one last chance in the half for England here from this corner. Mead to take everybody back for Belgium. In from Mead to the back post, controlled by Williamson. Filchin's tried to defend that one. And no time for one more ball into the box. A busy first half. Chances for both sides. Lauren Hemper threat throughout as always. England creating plenty of chances. Some good chances for Ellen White, who also felt she should have had a penalty as well. Best chance for Belgium fell to Feli Delacau. So an engrossing first half, but no goals in it. Half time, England 0, Belgium 0.
England are back in the Black Country. Smart stop by Everard. Lauren Hemp, Stanway wide. Surely Ellen White couldn't force it home. Williamson, lovely dig. Put the cover on the line.
Half time here at Molineux. England 0, Belgium 0. A number of chances that England have had and squandered. What do you make of it so far, Kelly?
Four or five chances, maybe six that. Very, should have put the ball away, but they haven't played bad. But these chances, if they would have put them away, the game would have been a lot easier for them. I think Lauren Hemp has been outstanding on the left, making those runs, diagonal runs, inside cutting. Beth Mead, when they switched, it was effective. But it hasn't been a bad performance, but
when you play in the Euros, these chances need to be put away because you will not win the tournament.
Before we see the chances, we want to show you the potential penalty shot. Yeah. The reason we're doing this is because it divided you two a little bit, didn't it?
Yeah, a little bit. Kels, what you thought it was a pendant. I thought that was one of the few times Demi Stokes has gone forward, to be honest. When it goes back in, I think she might get a little touch on it. I think it would have, for me, look, there. So I just thought...
It's a bit clumsy, though, isn't it? You can't do that. Yeah. There is the touch there, and she does come through, and there's a little tug there. So for me, that's a penalty. The ref, obviously, didn't give it.
Yeah. Well, we've been talking about these chances. It was 14 for England in the end, just in that first half. Let's have a look at them and see, perhaps, seeing where they could have done better.
Well, I think this one, Lucy Bronze, she kind of loses it there. But once we win this back, Beth Mead's balling is brilliant. And I think that when you look at someone like Ellen White, she's in the team to put them away. And I think that
she's got to score that.
Yeah, that's exactly right. I think Leah Williamson as well has been brilliant. But this, she has to hit the target there.
Yeah, that's a poor by Stanway. Should hit the target, make the keeper work. And here, Ellen White's a little bit unlucky. Just tries to toe poke it.
Yeah.
And then with this one
here. This is another great chance. This one comes down to Beth.
Oh, brilliant opportunity. Brilliant.
Brilliantly manufactured.
Week in, week out, that would go in for Arsenal.
Absolutely would. We've got to take them. We cannot be missing chances like that.
We saw this a little bit at the beginning of the World Cup qualifying campaign, didn't we? Where they were lacking that clinical edge. Yeah. What do you think it's down to now, Kelly?
Well, I haven't played in a couple of weeks. They've just been in training camp. So maybe that match fitness they've got a couple more games now, obviously the Netherlands and Switzerland, to hone that in. But they should be fresh coming into the tournament.
Yeah. Righty, one player that has been standout at both ends of the pitch has been Leah Williamson. She impressed you, right?
Yeah, very good in that number eight. You know, she's getting in the box. She's at the back there, making sure that she's just in front of that back four with Kira. But she's getting forward brilliantly. She really is getting forward brilliantly. She's getting... She's getting herself in positions where she's progressing the ball and she's getting herself into the places where she can be effective, joining in, helping the front players. Like here, when she gets moving here, here she goes now, right? Watch. Bam. Lovely stuff. Again, wants it. So she's playing a role that, yes, she's normally playing centre-half, but look at her now, off the back of the defender, and that is not a bad effort to try and finish. I love the way she's growing into this eight role. It's really good for her.
Mm. What do you think? What can we do in the second half?
We were talking about it watching the game. I think there's a diagonal ball that's on a lot with Millie Bright coming out to Lauren Hemp, and sometimes she's not seeing it. Lauren Hemp's putting her hand up saying, find me. And that, because Belgium are so tight and compact, it's hard to play through them. So sometimes that diagonal ball is on to Hempy.
So on.
OK, let's see what we can do in the second half. One thing that England do need to be wary of is on the counter-attack. When Belgium do have a chance, they've only had one of them in the game, but they did look a little bit dangerous. England's slightly vulnerable at the back there when the option is on. Can they do something in the second half? Can anyone score a goal? Join us next at Molyneux. New Street Football Show, looking at the best bits of the beautiful game. It's presented by the Beast, Adebayo Akinfenwa, and football freestyler Jack Downer. And you saw there, they are joined by guest Mikel Antonio. You can see the full episode. It's available to watch on ITV Sports YouTube channel now as the Lionesses make their way back out here at Molyneux. Here's the changes that have already been made, three of them. Chloe Kelly for Mead, Alex Greenwood's on for Lotta Wubemoy, Rachel Daly comes on for Stokes. What do you think of those changes, guys?
Well, it's giving people a chance to play. You know, we need something else. We need something else to happen. So hopefully, we're really excited to see Chloe Kelly. Want to see her taking some people on, getting it going. But yes, it's good changes. Give people some game time.
Yeah, at some point, I want to see Fran Kirby on. I want to see where she's at in terms of going into the tournament and then hopefully get Elisa Russo on for Ellen White and see what she can do. She's such a threat from set pieces. Yeah. And England's set pieces haven't been the best, but she offers you something different, a tall target to aim for.
You saw there, Belgium have made their changes as well. Hopefully we're going to see some goals in the second half. Loads of chances for England in the first. Just that one for Belgium in the second. We'll see what we can get. Emma Hayes and Seb Hutchinson, your commentary team, are ready to welcome you on for the second half.
Yes, thank you. Thank you very much. England making the three changes. Belgium making the two changes. But one of the England changes, very interesting indeed, Chloe Kelly. Back in an England shirt. We thought maybe this tournament might come too soon for her, but she's in the squad and she's going to play in this second half. She's replaced Beth Mead. Wubemoy and Stokes have gone off, but Greenwood and Daly, two regulars under Serena Wiegmann, but there is Chloe Kelly. former Arsenal, former Everton player, and at Manchester City, that ACL injury a year ago that kept her out for so long, but she returned to the second half of the campaign, and the talent was back. Two changes for Belgium as well. Tissiak, the defender. Thiessen, another defender. Two of those to come on. And here is Tissiak, who scored a hat-trick, would you believe, in that 19-0 victory over Armenia. So, centre-back pairing change for Belgium. Two young defenders as well. And an all Manchester City front three for England now. No surprise, a lot of Manchester City players in this England squad. But Hemp, White and Kelly. Here's Stanway, who was off Manchester City just a few weeks ago. Now Bayern Munich. Greenwood to Millie Bright. Is that the centre-back pairing we expect Serena Wiegmann to start with when the Euros come out?
Yeah, absolutely. I think Greenwood coming into the game will offer diagonal big ball threat from the left hand side. She's such a playmaker, and without Walsh getting on the ball, this is what England need another player that can bring the midfield into the game.
Here's Rachel Daly playing on the left hand side. Looks like she can play everywhere for England. As I said before, plays in forward areas for her club, Houston Dash in the United States, very much a defensive player. License to get forward in this England team. And on the opposite side, Lucy Bronze.
Well, clearly Serena wants a better attacking threat from left fullback, which Rach Daly will offer. Not naturally left footed, but will look to get forward. And with Chloe Kelly, I agree with the guys in the studio, it's important for her to get 45 minutes under her belt, see where she is at the international level. She's done so well to recover from her injury. Super talent.
Yeah, May 2021 was when the injury occurred. It's the Continental Cup final victory for Manchester City over Chelsea, but came back soon after that. Started the FA Cup final defeat to Chelsea. Here's Woolard. Losing that ball and already hunting down. There was Kelly. Chins forward. Woolard. Now couldn't get there. Bright stepping in. Williamson to link up with Stanway. And Williamson loses it. And here's Minard. Minard sending that forward. It's just going to run away. But they offered enough in that first half, Belgium, to pose a threat to this England defence, who haven't conceded a goal in World Cup qualifying.
I think under Wiegmann, it's one thing she's done really well, has tightened up the team defensively. But you can see there's a really clear style of play with Wiegmann's team. She likes high and wide fullbacks. And I think every opponent they face is going to look to exploit those areas.
Here is Bright. Now Bronze on to Kelly. Manchester City combinations out there, and then Bronze late with a challenge. She's going to get a booking here. Didn't seem to be much in it at first glance, but a yellow card all the same, the first of the game.
And it's always hard to comment on that from a distance. Couldn't see whether she'd made contact. Yeah, you can just see that hand across her face.
Evidently painful for Minard, who's down at the moment. Said it before in the first half, probably been Belgium's most eye-catching player.
She's done well. She just got to improve the last pass, been in good positions. Her final ball hasn't had the quality, I think, that's been needed. I think for England, especially this second half, it's important for Kelly in particular to get involved down this right-hand side and offer that threat out wide that I think so far Hemp has given.
Good pressure from Stanway to win it back, and Hemp is free. Stanway checks back though, looks for Kelly instead. And the moment's gone for England. Turns away, but Kelly was quick to press her. Stanway found a little bit of room there. Just to feed Kelly.
Again, England at their best. A quick ball recovery, creating good situation for themselves from that.
White to bronze. Mary Earps hasn't really had a save to make, despite a few chances Belgium have had to get forward. Greenwood, that's an excellent ball to Hemp. Stretching the play here. And Hemp looking for the nutmeg, couldn't quite squeeze it through.
I think Alex Greenwood has had her best season in the WSL this year. As I mentioned before, she's a playmaker, even from the deepest spaces. And other than the goalkeepers, her and Millie Bright have progressed the ball further in distance than anyone else in the league.
WSL PFA Team of the Year. So featured Lauren Hemp. Willard trying to link up. Again, comes to an end that move. Here's Bright. Lucy Bronze. Chloe Kelly. Kelly twisting back inside, looking for the foul. Just winced slightly when she turned sharply like that on that knee. Here's Walsh. Bright just too far ahead of Lucy Bronze. And we've spoken so much about that space behind Lucy Bronze and Millie Bright. They almost unfortunately exposed in that area because of that space left by Bronze.
Well, I think, especially in the second half, you can see England have taken up almost double width on both sides of the pitch because Belgium are sitting deeper.
Cover there from Daly. Decent. Getting it back again. Decent, one of the French speakers in this Belgium team. And again, feeding it forward. Stepping forward was Greenwood. Here's Woolard. Thiessen. For Minard. Dealt with by Bronze.
I think England need to increase the intensity the second half. Started the game quite flat-footed. Just need to move the ball with a little more urgency.
Greenwood looking for one of those raking passes again and finds her mark to Bronze, and Kelly tearing after this. Makes something out of that in the end. It's a heavy pass from Bronze.
Not for the first time, big ball from Alex Greenwood. Because I've seen in this game how difficult it's been for England's midfielders to get on the ball and create. Which is why I expect Fran Kirby to play some part in the game. Someone who's just going to come a little bit short, get on the ball, create a little bit of service into Ellen White.
To Siak under pressure. Will we see at some point the second half Fran Kirby? Here come England. And here goes Hemp, and sends it in towards White. It's good defending actually in there from Tisiak on the cover. And in the end, it's a goal kick.
Seeing Hemp in a natural position. I know we saw her on the right-hand side a lot in the first half. But clearly Wiegmann wants to keep her one side.
Well, there is Fran Kirby. Will we see a player part in this particular match? Is there a need to see a player part, Emma, before the tournament?
Yes, in my opinion. I think she's good to go. She's fresh. I know her well enough. She's raring to go. I think if she's to get any minutes tonight, I think it'd be a huge bonus for both her and England.
England winning that ball back. A loose pass from Belgium. Williamson, Kelly, Bronze. Here is Kelly. Digs that cross out, decent ball, just evades White. Hemp is there, so is Stanway. And a shot from Walsh straight at the goalkeeper. Well, Kira Walsh from range there hasn't scored for England.
But that's what Chloe Kelly brings you. It's not just the ability to go 1v1. She hits a deep cross really well. Goes beyond the front post. Set back by Stanway. Straight down the middle. Easy for Evrard.
Is Kira Walsh going close there? I think a rare opportunity to have a shot on goal. England. Like going to bring on Beth England, stripped and ready. Maybe Frank Kirby as well. Here's Bronze. Spotted the gap, plays it in, doesn't reach. Hemp, but does reach Stanway. How close was that one?
Again, across into the box. Set back for the second phases. This time with Bronze coming on the inside. Stanway's so good at bringing the ball down in areas like that. I've not seen her miss the target as much as she has done tonight. She's in good positions.
There's Bronze, just kneeing that into the path of Walsh. Goes down, look towards the referee, who's not interested. Sarah Pearson.
I don't think the referee wants to make a single decision tonight. I mean, she's let everything go.
Eastman's nicely done. Chin's out to that left-hand side of Minard, but just lost the ball there. Maybe looking a little tired, Minard.
I think Belgium are starting to get a bit stretched. In general, there's more space opening up for England.
Williamson working their way out here to Daly. Daly again. England, Bethany England and Kirby about to come on for England, but they might be in here with him. Decent control as well, pulling it back. Stanway sets herself, shot blocked. Decani. And Evrard under pressure here. Just squeezed it away from White.
Shows great composure. I think both of us were wondering where she was going.
Chloe Kelly with a challenge there. That will be a free kick to Belgium. I think more than that for the substitute. But England feel like they should have had another penalty here.
Again, if anything, it had been a free kick outside of the box. You can see just that standing leg. And it's a difficult one for the defender because as Hemp shifts the ball, she can't get out of the way.
Tisiak. Hutchins. Belgium are going to make a double change of their own as well. Cassandra Missipo, one of those to come on, the midfielder. And Alena Dont. Forward player. Decani. Loser. Thiessen. And Thiessen, it wide to Hernandez, who hasn't done much so far in this second half, but still hasn't. So we will see a double change for both sides. And it'll be England first. The Chelsea duo of Bethany England and Fran Kirby. Replacing Ellen White and Stanway. So it looks as though we will see Kirby in that 10 role. And Bethany England, who doesn't like to be called a super sub, but is pretty effective off the bench.
Impact player. I think no player likes doing it, but what we do have coming onto the pitch is a pairing used to playing at club level. Fran will know how to find Beth and vice versa. And just give Wiegmann the options I think she desperately needs to see. And I think it's the perfect game for England. Don't want this to be too comfortable. You want there to be problems to solve and players to come from the bench and make the impact that's necessary. I think Beth finished the season so well. It's a good opportunity for her.
Two changes for Belgium as well. One of those, Missipo, came on. It's one of those who plays abroad. Basel in Switzerland, who are England's last opponents of these three friendlies. The Swiss in Zurich, right at the end of the month. Here's Walsh. Bronze. Now Kelly. Three in the middle. And Kelly making space for herself. Deflected in! VAR deflection! But a perfect return for Chloe Kelly. So long out for injury, but back for England. And on the score sheets.
What she does is get the slice of luck I think that England haven't had all night. I'm so pleased for her. She's been out for a long time. The same piece of play, Lucy Bronze high and wide, except this time Kelly coming inside onto her left foot. See, it just takes that deflection at the near post. Sometimes that's all it needs in a game. Big deflection.
Well, if she gets given that goal, it will be her first goal for England, but we'll wait and see. Big deflection of Tissiak. What do you think, Emma? Give it to her?
Of course. After everything she's been through, absolutely.
Just the impact Serena Wiegmann would have wanted. Trying to slide that one through Greenwood, almost the perfect pass to Hemp. England winning that ball back quickly. Here's Walsh. And now Hemp. And England now with that advantage. And they'll push on here. Be sure a victory over Belgium. Here's Williamson.
Certainly the gaps have started to appear throughout the whole second half. When you make changes, it does take time.
Kirby. Hemp. Kirby just got away from her there. Sipo with the challenge. It seems just a little bit harder here for Belgium, though. All that energy from England in the first half, all that pressure, really paying off now.
And it's where the depth matters for England. We're seeing here with Kelly again. Lovely step over, drags the ball across the face of her opponent. Yes, I think it would have been a comfortable save for Everard, but there's been many chances missed by England tonight. It's the bit of luck they need, get the crowd going.
And the manager really enjoyed that goal as well. Williamson. Away from the challenge, Belgium winning it back, but they can't keep it for long at the moment. Here's Bright. Down the line for Bronze. all the Belgian players are professional. Professional fitness of the England side also playing its part as well. There's Bronze. Touch from Kirby. Williamson out to him. Pacey football from England. And here goes the Pacey Hemp. Tried to hang it in there for Beth England. Will be a corner.
Again, good patient play from England involving Frank Kirby to switch the ball. I just feel every time Lauren Hemp gets the ball, you know something's going to happen.
Very likely to be one of the stars of the tournament, whether England win it or not.
I don't think there's any doubt in that.
Warner played in low towards England. It's going to scoop up. It's awkward for the goalkeeper. Scramble defence. Oh! Brilliant, brilliant goal from Daly. Reacted to the situation and doubles England's advantage. And it's a lead they deserve in this second half.
Oh, absolutely. England spent the first half breaking this Belgium team down. Three subs at half-time. Chloe Kelly, one, scored, assisted a second. And Rach Daly in the second phases catches it so well. England got good numbers, especially in and around the second ball. Sweet strike, top corner. I'm sure the players will relax into the last part of the game, enjoy their football and push on for more goals.
And the sort of finish that has her amongst the top goal scorers in the top league in the United States. Just England's left back at the moment.
I think she's unlucky not to be in the starting lineup. I think she's performed very well every time she's played for Wiegmann. She will give an attacking threat down that left-hand side.
Who knows? Second half performances here might change a few thoughts in Serena Wiegmann's mind ahead of an opening game, European Championships. You looked at the starting lineup for this team and you thought maybe Greenwood for Ruben Moy and that might be the starting team, but there are plenty of players who will disagree with that.
I think the thing is, you mustn't get stuck on starting 11s. You know, it's a squad of 23.
Oh, and Wiegmann's almost losing it in her own box. Sipo getting the ball away. There's Minard. Roulant again trying to get involved for Belgium from deep. An excellent finisher, but hasn't had a chance to showcase that. Wiegmann's. Burnett playing it in or down the line. Don't. And the cover from Daly. And it is a goal kick. Everything going right for her at the moment.
I mean, back to the squad depth, I think it's one of the reasons why England are favourites is because of the quality and depth. And this player in particular, she plays right back, left back, up front, either wing, real team player.
I suppose that's the case in point. There are sides like Denmark and Norway who have some outstanding individuals. Do you just feel the side that wins this competition will be the one with the greatest squad depth? And that's why we can never discount Germany. Spain will be up there, I'm sure. France, Sweden.
That's why games like this are important. You need 45 minutes where you feel like it hasn't quite gone for you.
Here goes Hemp. There were four shirts around her at one point. But when she releases the ball, you feel like there's going to be space elsewhere. If she releases the ball. Doesn't have to most of the time. There's Mary Earps. Bright. England players, time on the ball. Point with some pressure there, though, on Daly. Here's Bronze. Greenwood just allowed the time to pick the pass, and Williamson had made the break. Bright. The bounce for Kirby. Still Kirby. Walsh. Hemp. Just got away from Herbert. England keep the ball. Williamson. That's a player's drawn towards Hemp. Williamson. He's had a very strong game. Powers away from the challenges as well. Williamson slipping it into England. A lot of England there. Willard clears, but England winning that ball back quickly.
They've certainly done that better. I think they've been better positioned second half to stop the counter-attacks.
Kelly. Kirby might not get there first. Tissiak has had some decent interceptions so far. Unfortunate with the goal. She'll hope it goes to Kelly as well.
Yeah, she's a good young prospect, Tissiak. Very good on the ball.
Williamson was down briefly. Kirby. Greenwood. And Daly. They're confident in their play at the moment. With good reason, a 2-0 lead. Taking a few chances as well. Bond's got away with that pass. Here's Greenwood. Now Hemp. Hugging the touchline, but not for long. Saw the gap. Into it. And finds England. And that's a chance for Beth England.
It is. But we need to talk about the impact Alex Greenwood's had being on this pitch. The timing and weight of her passing is exceptional. Quality ball into the box. Just see that Beth gets under it. But she's in a good position.
Well, Belgium making a double change. Jodie Van Hiller is one of those to come on. That's Davina Van Mechelen. It's a standard Liège in Belgium. And Jodie Van Hiller, the fullback, has come on as well. Belgium just need fresh legs at the moment. Haven't played too badly overall. Come up against a side of a higher quality overall.
Yeah, I think they've struggled a little more second half in their build-up because England's wide players have come a little lower. And as soon as the pass is then being made into the fullback, both Hemp and Kelly are in a better position to jump on the ball. I think it's suited England to just allow Belgium to come out a little bit, gain the ball in these areas, and then look to attack.
Well, next up for England, the Netherlands. A match you can see on ITV4 on the 24th of June. Second of the three friendlies before the tournament starts. And we've also got a final game as well in Zurich between Switzerland and England. Two sides, Switzerland and Netherlands, ranked higher than Belgium. And in the case of the Netherlands, the reigning European champions. And a side who maybe not tipped to win this competition, but still a side with plenty of quality, and plenty of familiar quality. The likes of Viviana Miedema, an Arsenal hotshot striker. Nico Martins, Barcelona winger.
I think that's the perfect next game for England. Really test themselves. Not one of the obvious favourites, but great experience.
And a great experience in winning on home soil. 4 years ago, the Dutch, under Serena Wiegmann. You need to be reminded again. Here's bronze, inside to Kelly, and working it on as well, and that is almost the perfect goal from Leah Williamson.
What a lovely piece of play down this right-hand side. Kelly and bronze, and it's combined really well. It's a lovely layoff, exquisite first touch. She just wraps her foot around the ball without even looking. She knows where the goal is. That deserved to go in the top corner.
Reaction says it all. Capped off. Excellent display in the midfield for England. Oh, this is awkward at the back though. And don't did well. And Willaert. Well, it fell to the player Belgium would have wanted it to fall to. But she's been feeding off scraps, really, and she plays that one over.
I think she didn't realise how much time she had. Greenwood going to ground. I think she could have took a touch. She had the time.
He spent a couple of seasons at Manchester City. Tessa Willaert has just left Anderlecht to move to a club in the Netherlands. From Tisiak. Minar. That's a clever ball. Willaert looking to pull it back as well. Just come back into the game a bit here, Belgium. Got in each other's way there. Not with a chance.
England not holding on to the ball very well. I think this area here, that little cutback space, has been on all night for Belgium.
And he'll be by that latest attack.
Well, I certainly think he'd be pleased with the team's first half performance. Second half, a little more sluggish, and I think by leaving the centre-backs in possession, realise Greenwood's got all the qualities of a centre midfielder in the way she sprays the ball around.
Belgium sit in the first half in that group in the Euros with Iceland, France and Italy. Brilliant ball from Millie Bright to Lauren Hemp. Now Daly, who scored the second goal for England, hangs it towards Bronze, who was stretching for it but couldn't keep it in.
So many problems coming from that big diagonal ball from the centre-backs.
Well,
such
nine,
a weapon.
Sorry, Emma, 9,500 in attendance tonight. Watching England put on a decent display in a strong second half display that's just taken the game away from Belgium. Well, we're seeing the fans, should comment on them. Here's Daly. Kirby couldn't take that in her stride. Deluza. Minar. And moving that ball wide. This is promising again for Belgium. I think the substitute's coming on, just giving them a bit more energy.
Yeah, it's not like they haven't put a great shift in. I think the fresh legs have certainly offered something else. They're finding space down that right-hand side, especially on the switch pass.
Sernils. Side here. 2-0 to one of the favourites for the competition. I know France will certainly be the favourites in their group. Italy probably second favourites, but Belgium still hoping to find a way through to the quarterfinals. There's Greenwood. Williamson. The favourites in their group with Norway, talented Norway side as well. Hemp takes the touch, moves into the space. Can she pick out a white shirt? She finds England. Tried to head it down, but comfortable for Everard.
Again, big ball from the back. They've got two players, done it so well in the league. Difficult header for Beth England.
England applying the press. Kirby couldn't work it on towards Kelly. Here's Minna. Spotted the run, couldn't feed teammate though. Woolart. Here's Walsh. Bronze looking to link up with Kelly. Just felt she was caught there by Minna. And here comes Nikita Paris, the depth of England's attacking areas. And off goes Lauren Hemp, a warm reception from the crowd. Won't be the last eye-catching display she'll provide. But what can Nikita Paris offer in the latter stages of this game?
I think a smart decision to get Hemp out. She is one player England cannot afford to be without.
England are comfortable in this game as it stands. No need to see any more for Lauren Hemp. We know what she can offer.
No, and a confident Nikita Paris, something I haven't always seen this year, is someone who could bring something unpredictable, especially in and around the penalty area.
It says a lot that even though Chloe Kelly joined this squad, Serena Wiegman didn't drop any of her forward players to make room for Kelly. Just kept them all. Bronze finds Kelly. And Kelly looks for Kirby. That's put behind for a corner.
One thing I like about Chloe Kelly is every time she gets into good areas, she picks her head up. She really does. She looks for the spare player or she looks for the space. Intelligent footballer.
And we hope we'll be given the goal tonight. Big deflection. Initial shot looked like it was on target. Greenwood towards the back post. Missipo missed it. Paris got there. And England will force it over at the end. And Williamson gets her goal to cap a fine performance from the England captain. And to cap what looks like is going to be a dominant victory for England.
Not for the first time tonight from a set piece. England very dangerous in the second phase. Concerned with the way Belgium are set up. Look at the space they've got from the penalty spot out to the edge of the box. It's been too easy, I think, for players. Daly for the second goal. Now Williamson, carbon copy, same error. You've still got to finish it. She stayed over the ball. No more than England deserved tonight.
I think that's going to go down as an own goal, perhaps. But England tearing forward again. Paris tried to force it on. Very useful player off the bench, Nikita Paris. But here's Woolan trying to slip it through and Don trying to get there. But the flag's up. But Daly didn't know that. Good recovery in the end.
That's what Rachel Daly will give you, that pace to get backwards, because it's the same space again behind Lucy Bronze. That little slip pass. Marginal offside, but great recovery from Rachel Daly.
No VAR, no goal line technology for this particular game, but there will be VAR for the match between England and the Netherlands at Elland Road. Preparation for tournament football.
Well, I think England are going to go into the tournament confident, particularly in their wide areas. With Beth Mead, Chloe Kelly, Lauren Hemp. Got players who are very good 1v1. I think with Nikita Paris, with that element of surprise, they've got pace everywhere.
And here is one of those examples in Paris. Couldn't quite get to that. Disappointing season for Nikita Paris. Coming to Arsenal, only one WSL goal. But Serena Wiegmann knows the quality she does possess and the impact she can provide, hence why she's included her in the squad. It's Tissier. The loser. It's moved across to that the fullback position as she can do. Filchien's going off. McKillen. There were no goals in the first half, but England have risen to the occasion in the second half. Found three goals in the end, two of which could go down as own goals, certainly that third one. Paris. Such a busy player. Relentless presence in the front line. That's Kirby. Kirby. Back to Greenwood. Bright. There's Walsh. Looks like she might finish the game. Greenwood. Couldn't find Kirby. But always looking to be progressive, Alex Greenwood. And Daunt to Minar. She's kept on going. And they'd have a player down here. They're carrying on, but you fancy they might put it out. Daly down at the moment.
Well, I think Daly is going to be needed because Alex Greenwood plays on the edge. She wants to come into midfield with the ball, and I think there is space behind her for the opponent to get at. But I think the great thing about having Alex Greenwood in the team is that teams can't always defend her and Kira Walsh. And you've seen, ever since Alex has been on the pitch, Kira Walsh has come into the game.
That could only be a good thing for England. Daly just taking a knock to the face from the shoulder of Minar. She's able to continue. Greenwood, another raking pass, finds Paris. Still Paris. Trying to find the route, trying to force her way through, but well defended in the end. Daunt back there for Belgium. England aggressively trying to win that ball back quickly, with Walsh involved as well, and Paris with a foot in. Somehow Mechelen holding on to it, but not for much longer. Daly. And England have made all these substitutions, but there's not been a drop in quality at all. Decani. Featured for Hoffenheim in the Champions League against Arsenal. Learned anything new about this England team in this performance, Emma?
Just a reminder that we're at our best when they're big balls from the back or Kira Walsh in behind the fullback. I think England's strengths are getting it out to the wide areas.
As an example, case in point with Kelly.
But I think that's indicative of Wiegmann. I think the Netherlands team played the same way. And I think in Bright and Greenwood, you've got players who can put the ball into those areas.
Course, test in their defence. Yeah, bigger test against the Netherlands, that's for sure. Willard. There's Greenwood taking a chance again. When you're 3-0 up with a couple of minutes left, it's worth a go. Belgium have also shown that they are a side that can defend pretty well. The They've got those players behind the ball. Can offer enough in attack, but just not enough to beat England today. They have drawn with England a couple of times in their last three meetings. Ball going long. Can they just have the final say here, Belgium? They might. Here's Minnaert. Still Minnaert. Woollard. She get on the score sheet late on. That's a decent ball, but it's straight. And Earps in the end. And a chance in the end for Van Mechelen.
Well, so many of Belgium's chances have missed the target. Not this one. Good ball into the box from Woollard. Just not enough power in the ball to redirect it beyond Earps. Probably the first save she's had to make all night.
All year, it feels like. Think back to the two excellent saves she made against Austria. What it's ultimately going to prove to be a decisive home victory in World Cup qualification, because Austria went on to draw with Northern Ireland, which means if they are to pip England to top spot in the group, they'd have to beat them and hope that England drop points at home to Luxembourg. Unlikely, you would fancy. Here's Kelly. Now England had a really good chance in the second half. Bronze, Kelly couldn't take it on. So one final goal in this for the home side. As it stands, it looks as though England not going to concede either. Very good defensive record so far under Serena Wiegman. Here's Bronze. Sending that ball in towards Beth England. It will be a corner, probably the last of the game.
Again, good play from Lucy Bronze on this right-hand side. Whips a lovely ball across the face of the goal.
To Greenwood. Last chance for England to add to their tally. 30 seconds to go in this game. I can't imagine there'll be too much more added, being a friendly match. But England, another win under their belt, under this manager. Bronze. Kirby. Just got away from her there. Here's Williamson.
She needs minutes. You can tell she hasn't had them. No, just to get your touch right, get everything right.
Well, Belgium beaten and England still unbeaten under Serena Wiegman. A smile on her face, and so there should be. In the end, strong second half performance took the game away from Belgium. Goals from Chloe Kelly, Rachel Daly, and what will probably go down as an own goal from Williamson's shot going off the goalkeeper, Evrard. Means that England have started their run of three friendlies with a comfortable victory at Molineux, picking up a win that showcased again that they are a side with good squad depth, a side who should do well on home soil. But there's a bigger test to come next time up against the Netherlands. But they've done the job tonight. Comfortable victors at home to Belgium by 3-0.
Well, 3 half-time substitutions for Serena Wiegman had the desired effect. First England appearance under Serena and a goal for Chloe Kelly. That was 1-0. The second came from another one off the bench, Rachel Daly making it 2-0. And then Leah Williamson for her performance today for the Lionesses, a captain's performance, both ends of the pitch. So impressive. She did deserve a goal. Unfortunately, it will go down as Belgium's keeper's goal, Nikki Everard. But a goal, well, three goals in the end, and a much important win for that woman there, Serena Wiegmann, who is speaking to her 23 women team. Why don't we hear from our first goal scorer, Chloe Kelly? She is speaking to Katie Shanahan.
Chloe, a dream return for you after a year out, after such a struggle with the injury and scoring your first England goal too. Could tonight have gone any better?
No, it couldn't have. It was brilliant to be back out there with the girls, and yeah, I'm just enjoying my football, so to get a goal, it was an amazing experience to be back on the pitch, but to get a goal was brilliant.
You were out for so long with that serious injury. Did you ever lose faith that you'd be able to come back and perform like this in an England shirt, let alone be going to the Euros?
No, definitely not. From the minute I got injured, I said I wanted to be at the Euros, and I worked so hard each day. So, yeah, being back out on the pitch, it's great to be out there. But I realise how much hard work I put in my rehab, and you see the greatness when you come back and you've put that hard work in.
It was your first game under Serena. I saw you having a chat with her before you came on, also high fives from the girls as well. What does Serena say to you, and also the role she wants from you in the squad?
Yeah, to be attacking player, to be my player 1v1, to get balls in the box and just to enjoy myself back on the pitch. Yeah, so that's what I did tonight. I tried to get on my player 1v1 and I enjoyed every minute of being back out there. So it's great to be back in and around the girls.
And you're facing the European champions, the Netherlands, up next. How much of a test is that going to be?
Yeah, it's going to be a great challenge. And each challenge we get now that faces us is just to get us ready for the 6th of July. So, yeah, it'll be a great challenge and another step in the right direction.
Well, that is one player that we wanted to see, and we were hoping she was going to be brought on at some point. She came off the bench, she had an impact straight away. Were you impressed with how she performed, Kelly?
I was, yeah. Full of confidence, the lack of game time that she's had, but to see her go in 1v1, getting the crosses in, picking players out that are coming in, trailing the back post. I like the understanding that she has with Lucy Bronze, even though she's been out for a while. They had a good interchanging of positions, really good connection down that right-hand side.
They needed this goal, didn't they, Ian?
Well, we didn't need it, and it's the luck we deserve, to be honest. We missed too many chances in the first half, but she is a player that comes on and wants to commit defenders. You know, she's coming on, she's showing a lot of energy, closing down, doing what she's doing, and she's got a good link-up with Lucy Bronze because obviously they play together, but it's her positivity, it's a great cross. I think that she's got to do better in the middle there. That ball's right in the middle of the box. Ellen White was up with her smaller defender. She should have done better with that because this is the quality that she can bring. You know, and I was pleased for her because, like, again, she's taking it here. She's come inside and she's got a bit of luck, you know, because she's taking someone on. She's doing something positive. Absolutely delighted for her for what she's been through.
That's it, to come back from that injury, which was a serious injury, but as well, and to have confidence. Yeah. It takes a while sometimes.
Well, you know, I spoke to her she a couple of weeks ago about it, and she was saying how sad it was, and how she, you know, she spoke to people like Jordan Knobbs, kept herself going, using the Euros as the target for her to get back without rushing herself, because you know you want to get there, but you want to make sure that you do it on time. So for her to be here in the squad and scoring now will give her a massive, massive boost.
The second goal came from another substitute as well, named Rachel Daly, and it felt a little bit more like when those changes were made, it just had, all three of them had such an impact.
Yeah, she down that left-hand side, you know, she's so versatile as a left back or a forward, but she just, the ball comes out in the second phase and she just gets her feet correct, you know, a great left footed strike, gets her head over the ball. She's just waiting for it, and there it drops. Great, great strike from the left-back position. But she was a threat going forward, and recovery runs. When the ball was breaking down the England side, she was getting back, making sliding tackles. She was a threat going forward, coming back. Brilliant player to come on.
Right, is she a starter for you?
I think she is a start for me for left-back. What we saw in the first half from Demi Stokes, unfortunately, was somebody that's first thought is not to go forward, and especially when you've got someone like Lauren Hemp in front of you, what you want to do, you want to get the ball off the centre half, get it to her as quickly as you possible and go and support her. I found that Demi Stokes in the first half, she got the ball, she kept turning back the other way. With Rachel Daly, she wants to get forward, she wants to be progressive and she wants to attack, and I think that's what we need to be doing.
Well, these are examples of her getting back as well, doing that work too, Kelly.
Yeah, exactly. She puts her body on the line, the correct choice there. You know, she's in recovery runs here, makes the right decision, puts her body on the line there, wins the tackle, gets a foul. She's a calm and influence on that side, and she's got so much experience of playing in America, so versatile. She's a great team player to have.
This is it. This is what they say about her as well. When she plays in America for Houston Dash, she plays as a fullback, yeah. She plays as a centre-forward as well. She makes herself so important to the hierarchies, not just in America, but here in England as well.
And then, and in all the positions she plays in, she contributes. So she's somebody that she's obviously happy being versatile.
I'd hate that.
I know. I probably wouldn't like that myself. Like that. I probably wouldn't like myself. But
see my left back, though.
But the fact that she's coming, it's got her in the squad because she is so versatile. And she's coming at second half and proven that she's for me, is a starter.
Now, we were speaking at halftime about just how good Leah Williamson had been throughout the game,
yeah.
Both ends of the pitch. Yeah. And then in the second half, she eventually got a goal, but actually, it wasn't a goal in the end.
Yeah, but the thing is with Leah is that she's in the team predominantly as that holding midfielder with Kira Walsh. But what I found in this game that she got herself in forward positions, especially in the second half when it opened up a bit more for us with Belgium. Not so much dropping off, but we've got better movement with Beth, with Chloe Kelly, you know. And so she was then able to get herself in positions where she could pick the ball up in those little pockets and make like more of an impact on the game.
She's better playing higher up from seeing this performance. You know, you're used to seeing her playing as a centre-half for Arsenal, but when she's playing in that position, that eight, she can turn, dictate play, take players on, make that through pass. She's really, really effective higher up the pitch.
This is glorious. Now I can actually hear you both properly. The gear system's gone down. It looks like everybody's finally left. We'll get more reaction from Serena, from some of the players as well, after this very quick break. But England, they remain unbeaten under Serena Wiegmann. 12 games in her reign, 10 wins, and 2 draws, and it means the world to these girls. More reaction after the break. MotoGP action to look forward to on Sunday as the championship heads to Germany for round 10 of the season. We start here on ITV4 at 9:30 with the Moto3 and Moto2 races, and then it's over to ITV for the build-up to the MotoGP race at the Sachsenring from 12:30. Well, Serena Wiegmann will no doubt be happy, especially with that second half performance. Why don't we hear from her now? She is speaking to Katie Shanahan.
Serena, you had to be patient, but you got the job done in the end. Sum up tonight for us.
I think we dominated the game. The first half, we already did that too. We created lots of chances, but we didn't score in the first half. Gave away one chance to the Belgium. So we said at halftime that we wanted a little more depth, runs behind, keep the patience, switch fields, and score some goals from the chances we create.
A few standout performances tonight, including that of Chloe Kelly. After everything she's been through, how pleased are you for her?
Well, yes, I'm very happy for her, of course, and it's so nice that then she scores a goal. Doesn't matter who scored the goal, but after what she's gone through, and now she's back. Getting her first minutes with the national team and scoring a goal. You could tell that it did something to her too and to the team. Very nice.
If you had VAR tonight, you could have had a few penalties. Do you think you missed out on a few penalty shouts?
Yes, I think so. But then when we don't get it, I go next to the next moment right away. So at least one. But yeah, we didn't get it. So yeah.
Are you happy from what you've seen tonight with the direction of the squad, where they're going, bearing in mind there's only 20 days until the Euros?
Yeah, I think so. Like many players have played tonight, and I think that it had impacted the game of all of them, so it shows how the depth in the team is, and we still could bring in some other players too, but the rules don't let it. So yes, what we wanted to do tonight, of course we want to win, but we also wanted to try out some other things. And I think that gave us lots of information where we can continue with working on tomorrow.
And the Netherlands are up next, your home, your former team. How big is that going to be for you personally?
Yeah, it's going to be a special game, of course. So, of course, it's a game for the preparation for the Euros, so we won't approach it differently. But it's special because it's the country I come from.
Thanks, Rina. Well done tonight.
Thank you.
It will be a special occasion, and luckily we've got it for you live on ITV4. That one is Friday the 24th of June, 7:15. Serena Wiegmann won the Euros with the Netherlands, and now she's with England. We face them next as our second game in this international friendlies group. And then we've got Switzerland against England Thursday the 30th of June as well. That one is at 4:30. Both of those on ITV for you. Now, if Emma Hayes wasn't busy enough during the game, we managed to bring her down. We wanted a quick chat with her as well. Emma, thank you for joining us. First of all, your thoughts from where you were sat on that whole performance?
Yeah, I think a good all-round performance from England, where they built off the first half, where they didn't take chances, showed the impact from the bench and the depth that we've got. And I think in this type of game, I think you'd rather be in that position at 0-0, where you get to see players come into the game. I think a brilliant situation for Chloe Kelly to come in. The importance of Alex Greenwood to the team, I think, was really, really important in telling. And how crucial set-piece goals are going to be for England, because it's an area where we're really, really strong.
Tell us more about Alex Greenwood, because she had her injury. She also suffered with COVID as well. She came back off the bench and she was really instrumental today.
She's a playmaker from the deepest spaces. And I mentioned in commentary that both her and Millie Bright,
what a combination those two would be.
Yeah, their deep balls are their strengths, and putting balls into areas where Hemp can get onto made it difficult for Belgium, because as much as they shut Kira Walsh off, Greenwood in the second half had the ability to hit the raking diagonal ball, which allowed these situations time and time again. And I think that takes the pressure off of Millie Bright, who's equal at doing that. And I think that having that ability for England is a game changer. It really is. And I think teams playing against them, I'll be curious to see if they defend England's two centre-backs, who are two huge playmakers for England.
Right, that was something that you were crying out for in the first half, more of those diagonal balls, more accuracy.
Yeah, because I found that when we were trying to build it up through, whether it was through Lotta Wibbermoy or it went out to Demi Stokes, I didn't think it got to Lauren Hemp quick enough. And I thought that once they dropped back, I found that the right back, she kind of went over too far to the centre-half and that ball was on, but we weren't hitting it. And I think that if we'd done that a bit more, we could have got the ball to Lauren Hemp a bit quicker and then she could have done her stuff. But no, I think they started pretty well, Belgium, and stopped us. And I thought they deserved the luck they were getting defending us. But in the second half, the quality just showed them, especially with the substitutions.
How much in that second half, Kelly, did you feel in comparison to the first, where perhaps they weren't quite on it? The second half now, how much confidence does that fill you with, deciding that we are, 20 days away from the start of the Euros?
Yeah, massive amount of confidence, especially with the chances that we created. I know they weren't clinical enough the first half. We got the three goals in the second half. But what impressed me most was Lauren Hemp, Chloe Kelly, Fran Kirby to some extent. Good to see her back, but she does need more game time. But it's good that we've taken so many opportunities. Obviously, a big game up next in the Netherlands. That's the next test, because they're the holders.
Serena must be doing something right, because they're unbeaten under her. And I know a lot of those are World Cup qualifiers against teams that, of course, you would expect to beat, because there's such a goal for difference in class and quality. But what do the players say, Emma? Because they must be coming to you and talking to you about her a little
She's
bit.
Doing lots right. She's got a lot of experience. She's a winner. She's a champion. She's put structure into the team. Very clear principles in and out and possession. And she's not complicating it. I think players are very clear on where they stand, whether that's their role from starting position, the bench. You heard before the game how she spoke to every player about whether they were in or out of the squad. She's got great communication skills. Good experience.
And it's that personal touch that you were talking about. We heard Leah speaking about it, how it wasn't just a message or an email or something like that. She actually went one-on-one as a player. And is that something that worked for you?
Yeah, it did work for me. I remember Graham Taylor told me when I won the Golden Boot in 92 that I weren't going. I could have done without the personal touch, if I'm being totally honest. But then I remember Glenn Hoddle came in and gave a personal and told you, you are going. You do. It is something that's why I was quite surprised that it's obviously for reasons it was announced the day before a game. Because it was something that I was thinking about for days leading in, because I was so worried about whether I was going to be in or weren't, whether I weren't going to be out, but be in there. But then when they tell you, yeah, it's nice when you see someone face to face and they tell you why you're in it and they tell you what you're bringing to it, and then all of a sudden you're ready to go.
Emma, anything watching that performance that you feel that England should really specifically work on?
I think they're good from set pieces. We're unbelievable in wide areas, and I think our ability to open up the opponent with bigger balls are our three strengths.
And what's going to happen for us if people notice that, okay, we'd stop Greenwood, stop the ball into Kira Walsh, what are we doing next? We're going to need our, like, Lauren Hemp and then probably the Chloe Kellys to make things happen then.
Yeah, that means you're going to have to go to lots of double width. There's a lot of short balls going around, then it's 1v1 situation. That might then leave the nine isolated. Mm. I think with Fran Kirby, you have a player who can come into drop into midfield areas and get on the ball. I felt Stanway could have done a bit more of that tonight.
We'd love to talk even more to you three. Thank you so much. You've been wonderful company. We've got another two games before the Euros. Emma, thank you for your help tonight as well. Kelly, Righty, brilliant as always. Thank you very much for watching as well. And don't forget, Royal Ascot continues tomorrow at 1:30 with the opening show at 9 a.m. And on Saturday, the two best teams in English rugby meet in the Premiership final. Leicester take on Saracens from 2:15 on ITV4. And then there is a chance to see the much-anticipated behind-the-scenes documentary, Two Sides, which explores what happened in the Springbok and Lions camp during the 2021 tour of South Africa. You can see all three episodes on ITV and STV starting on Sunday, 10:20. Should be really worth tuning in for. Thank you so much for watching. 20 days to go and two more friendlies to see before that. See you next time.
Bye.
Smart stop by Evran. Lauren Hemp. Williamson, lovely dink. Kelly deflected in. Brilliant, brilliant goal from Daly. And Williamson gets her goal.